Hello, 7th class. A very good morning to all of you. I hope you are all doing very well. In our previous classes, we were doing chapter number 2, that is fractions and decimals. In exercise 2.1 and 2.2, we have already covered topics like types of fractions, that is improper, mixed and proper fraction. A proper fraction means numerator is greater than denominator. Proper fraction means numerator is less than denominator, and mixed fraction means you have whole number and then with a proper fraction. We have also done multiplication of a whole number with fraction. Now we are doing multiplication of a fraction with another fraction. For this we have four steps. Step number one is convert any mixed fraction to improper fraction. Second step is cancel out if something is common in both numerator and denominator. Step 3 is product, that is required product is equal to product of numerators divided by product of denominators. Step 4 is if result or the product comes out to be an improper fraction, then convert it to a mixed fraction. Okay, for multiplication of fraction with another fraction we will be following four steps. First is, if we have any mixed fraction, then we will convert that mixed fraction to improper fraction. Second is, if there is some term which is common in both numerator as well as denominator, we will cancel that out. Step third is, required product will be equal to product of numerators divided by product of denominators. And fourth one will be, if the result comes out to be improper, you will convert it back to mixed fraction. Your answer will always be a mixed fraction or a proper fraction. Now we will do few questions from exercise so that we can understand this concept completely. First one is question number 1, part 1. We have to find out 1 by 4th of, then A 1 by 4, B 3 by 5, C 4 by 5. Okay, we will first solve A part, which is 1 by 4th of 1 by 4. Okay, of here means 1 by 4 into 1 by 4. Now, product of numerators divided by product of denominators, it will be equal to 1 by 16. This is a proper fraction, so this will be the answer. In B part, it will be 1 by 4th of what? 3 by 5. 1 by 4th of 3 by 5. It means it is equal to 1 by 4 cross 3 by 5. Product of numerators divided by product of denominators, it is 3 by 20. It is a proper function, so this will be the answer.
Similarly, in C part, 1 by 4th of 4 by 5. C part, 1 by 4th of 4 by 5. It will be equal to 1 by 4 into 4 by 5. As 4 appears in both numerator and denominator, we can cancel this out. It will be equal to 1 into 1 by 5 or 1 into 1 by 1 into 5, that is 1 by 5. It will be the answer. Similarly, part B, we can do apply the same process. Then we have the multiply. Question number 2 is multiply and reduce to lowest form. We have to multiply and then reduce to simplest form. Question number 2, first part. It is 2 by 3 into 2 by 3. As there is a mixed fraction in the product, we will try to convert it into improper fraction. Also, convert kaise karenge? Yes, if you can remember completely, we have to multiply here and then add here. 2 3 is 6, 6 plus 2, 8 by 3, that is 8 by 3. No cancellation, so 2 into 8 upon 3 into 3, that is 16 by 9. It is an improper fraction, so we will convert it into mixed fraction, that is 6, we will divide 9 by 16 by 9, 7, so it will be 1, 7 by 9. We will follow this circle. Okay, so this will be your simplified answer. Okay, next we will do part second also. In part second, we have 2 by 7 into 7 by 9. Here 7 is present in both numerator and denominator, so we can cancel this out. So we are left with 1 by 9, or we can write it as 2 into 1, product of numerator, product of denominator, that is 2 by 9. It is a proper fraction, so we can leave it as it is. Similarly, we can solve all the other parts of question number 2. Question number 3 is, multiply the following fractions. We will do two parts, first and second. In first, we have 2 by 5 into 5, 1 by 4. We will convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. 5 folds are 20, 20 plus 1. Multiply plus 20, 1 by 4. So 20, 1 by 4. Cancellation, yes, we can cancel out. 2 1s are 1, 2 2s are 4. It is 1 by 5 into 21 by 2, product of numerators and divided by product of denominators. It will be 21 by 10. Now our answer is an improper form. We will convert it into mixed form. We divide 21 by 10, 21. We will complete a circle, use a circle. I will write it as 1, 1 by 10. This will be our answer. I hope it is clear. Then part 2 is again multiplication. It is 6 2 by 5 into 7 by 9. First step is convert any mixed fraction into improper fraction. So 5, 6 is 30, 30 plus 2, 32 by 5 into 7 by 9. Some cancellation, can we do some cancellation? No. So 32 into 7 divided by 5 into 9, it is 45. 2, 20 24 by 45. It is an improper fraction. We will convert it into mixed fraction. This will be our answer. Okay. Similarly, we can solve all the other parts. They will follow the same process. Now we will move on to question number 4. In question number 4, we have to tell which one is greater. We have to first do the multiplication, find out the result, and then tell which one is greater. Aapke paas do parts given hai. First part we will do. It is 2 by 7. Of 3 by 4 or 3 by 5 of 5 by 8. We will simplify this one this side and this one this side. It means it is equal to 3 by 4. We can cancel this out. It will be equal to 1 into 3 divided by 7 into 2. It will be 3 by 14 and 5. It will be equal to 3 into 1, 1 into 8 or 3 by 8. We have to tell if this one is greater or this one is greater. So we will do the comparison. I will erase it and the steps. Okay, we have 3 by 14 or 3 by 8. For this, we will cross multiply. For comparing the fractions, we will cross multiply. It is equal to 3 into 8 or 3 into 14. 24 or 42. This one is greater, this one is greater, this side is greater, as 24 is less than 42. It means, it implies that our left hand side is less than our right hand side in our question. Now we will move on to next question. Question number 5 says that Sally plants 4 saplings in a row in her garden. Question number 5. Sally plants 4 saplings in her garden in a row. The distance between 2 adjacent saplings. 2 adjacent saplings is 3 by 4 meter. Find the distance between first and last sapling. You have to tell distance, this distance. Okay. So, we will first write distance between two adjacent saplings is 3 by 4 meter. It means distance between first and last sapling we have 4 saplings, and so this distance is thrice of this. As you can clearly see, it is thrice of this. Now we will multiply this whole number with this fraction. Multiply whole number with numerator of this. 3 threes are 9 by 4. That is 9 by 4 meter. And since it is an improper fraction, we will convert it into So this will be the answer to 1 by 4 meters. Now question number 6. Question number 6 is, Lipika reads a book for 3 by 4 hours every day. She reads the entire book in 6 days. How many hours in all were required by her to read the book? Okay, given kya hai aapko? That she reads for 3 by 4 hours per day. Theek hai? In one day, question number 6, in one day, Lipika reads for how many hours? How many hours? 3 by 4 hours. Okay. And she completes the entire book in 6 days. So in six days, she will read for how many hours? 3 by 4 times 6. This much hours, or you can write it as 4 times 4 plus 3, 7 by 4 into 6. It will be 7 into 6 by 4. Okay. Again, this is an improper fraction. We will convert it into proper fraction. It will be 4 by 4 hours. Now, question number 7. Question number 7 is, a car runs for 60 km using 1 liter of petrol. How much distance will it cover using 3 by 4 liters of petrol? ठीक है, आपको क्या गिवन है? In 1 liter of petrol, कार कितना रन करती है? कार रन्स फॉर 16 किलोमीटर्स. इट रन्स फॉर 16 किलोमीटर्स. आपको कितने में डिस्टेंस कवर करना है? इन 2 3 by 4 liters. इन 2 3 by 4 liters of petrol, it will run for how much kilometers? 2 3 by 4 into 16, that is, convert it into improper fraction, 4 to the 8, 11 by 4 into 16, we can cut it, 11 into 4, that is 44 kilometers. This is your answer. And question number 8, we have two parts, so we'll do one and you can try another one. A part is, provide the number in the box such that, aapko kya given hai, 2 by 3 into dash will be equal to 10 by 30. It means we have to find a number here and here such that if you multiply this numerator with this numerator, it comes out to be 10, and if we multiply this numerator with this number, it will come out to be 30. So number will be, by what number 2 should be multiplied so that we get 10? So this number should be 5 by 10. Then we have to write the simplest form. 5 by 10. We can cancel this out. Yes. Kitni table mein dono aate hai? 5. 5 ones are 1. 5 ones are 10. It is 1 by 2. Further cancellation possible nahi hai. It means this is our answer, required answer. Okay. After this, we will move on to exercise 2.4, which consists of division of a whole number with fraction or division of fraction with a fraction. ठीक है? To solve division with fractions, we have to understand the concept of reciprocals in fractions. So, reciprocal of of a fraction. What does it mean? Okay, the non-zero numbers, number should not be zero. The non-zero numbers whose product with each other is zero, is one, are said to be reciprocals of each others. Okay, we can take some examples like 5 and 1 by 5. If we multiply 5 and 1 by 5, it will cancel out, we will get 1. So 5 and 1 by 5 are 5 and 1 by 5 are reciprocals of each other. Iska meaning hai, 5 is a reciprocal of 1 by 5 and 1 by 5 is a reciprocal of 5. Okay, now we will use this concept of reciprocal in our division. Suppose we want to do a division with fraction. It is 2 by 3 divided by 4 by 5. Okay, this division is equivalent to 2 by 3 multiplied by reciprocal of 4 by 5. And how will you find reciprocal of 4 by 5? You will interchange the numerators and denominators. So reciprocal of 4 by 5 will be 5 by 4. Okay, now we already know the how to perform the multiplication. Product of numerators divided by product of denominators, 2 into 5 divided by 3 into 4, we can cancel this out. It is 1 into 5 by 3 into 2, that is 5 by 6. This will be our answer. Okay, so it's quite easy. It means we have to use concept of multiplication and reciprocal for division. We have to know how to find out the reciprocal and how to perform the multiplication to find out divisions with fractions. Now we will do some questions from exercise 2.4. Question number 1, we have to perform some divisions. We will do few parts, and then first one is 12 divided by 3 by 4. It means it is equivalent to multiplication reciprocal of 3 by 4. Reciprocal of 3 by 4 will be equal to 4 by 3. What we did, we interchange numerators and denominators. It is, can we cancel out? Yes, 3 1 is 1, 3 4 is 12. It is 4 into 4 by 1, that is 16. So our answer is 16. Next is part number 5. We will do part 5. Part 5, we have a mixed fraction, and we already know that to perform multiplication or division, first we have to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. 3 to the 6 by 3. Now this is similar to first part. It means it is equal to multiplication reciprocal of 7 by 3, which will be equal to 3 into 3 by 7. It will be equal to 3 into 3, that is 9 by 7. It is an improper fraction. It means you have to convert it into mixed fraction. 1, 2 by 7. This will be your answer. One thing you have to remember is you just can't cancel out 3 and 3 here. Okay, you can cancel something out only in multiplications. Okay, and multiplication mein to yahan pe ye dono upar same place par hai, you cannot cancel out again. Okay, We can do sixth part also to understand it completely. In sixth part, we have 5 divided by 3, 4 by 7, or we can write it as 3 divided by, convert it into improper fraction. It will be equal to multiplication, reciprocal of 25 by 7. That means it will be 7 by 25. We interchange numerators and denominators. We can cancel out something. Yes. 5 is a 25. 1 into 7 by 5. That is 7 by 5. This is an improper fraction. We will convert it into mixed fraction. 1, 2 by 5. This is your answer. Okay. Next, we will move on to question number 2. Question number 2 is, you have to find out the reciprocals of each fraction and you have to classify the reciprocal as proper, improper and whole numbers. Okay? First is 3 by 7. Reciprocal of 3 by 7. Kya hoga aapka? 7 by 3. It is 7 by 3 is improper fraction. Reason kya hai aapka? Reason is because numerator is greater than aapka denominator. We will do two more parts, 6th and 7th. 6th one mein we have, in 6th part we have 1 by 8, reciprocal of 1 by 8, numerator to denominator, so it will be 8 by 1 and we can write 8 by 1 as 8, so it is a whole number, 8 is a whole number, okay. If we have 1 as denominator, it means it is a whole number. And 1 by 11, 6th part, 1 by 11 mein kya hoga? If 1 by 11, again we will follow the same procedure, reciprocal of 1 by 11 will be, 11 by 1 or 11, which is a whole number again. Okay. Now we will move on to question number 3. Question number 3, we have to perform the division of a fraction with a whole number. First part is, you have to do 7 by 3 divided by 2. Okay. It means it is equal to 7 by 3 into reciprocal of 2. You know ki 2 can be written as 2 by 1. It means reciprocal of 2 is 1 by 2, or you can guess by using the definition of reciprocals, which says that two non-zero numbers whose product is 1. Product 1 kab hoga? When we have 2 in denominator, that is in 1 by 2. Here it will be 7 into 1, 3 by 2, product of numerator divided by product of denominator, 7 by 6, it is an improper fraction, we will convert it into mixed fraction, 1 by 6, this will be our answer. Now part 2, third question itself, 4 by 9 divided by 5, it will be equivalent to 4 by 9 into reciprocal of 5, reciprocal of 5 will be 1 by 5, why? Because if you multiply 5 with 1 by 5, will get result 1, 4 into 1, 9 into 5, 4 by 45, it is a proper fraction, so we will leave it here. Next question, third part is as it is, we will move on to fourth part, we have to perform this division. First, we will convert this mixed fraction to improper fraction. It will be 13 by 3 divided by 3, or 13 by 3 into reciprocal of reciprocal of 3, which will be equal to 1 by 3, 13 by 3 into 1 by 3, it will be 13 into 1, 13, 3 into 3, that is 13 by 9. It is an improper fraction, convert it into mixed fraction, 4 by 9, this will be our answer. Okay? Rest two parts are the same, we can solve them easily. We will move on to question number 4. Question number 4 may we have division of two fractions. Okay? Question number 4. First part is 2 by 5 divided by 1 by 2. It is equivalent to 2 by 5 into reciprocal of 1 by 2, which will be equal to 2. Reason being, if you multiply 2 and 1 by 2, you will get 1. It is multiplication of fraction with whole number. We will multiply whole number with numerator and then leave the numerator. It is 4 by 5. It is a proper fraction, so we will leave it here. This will be our answer. Part 2, 3 are same, so we will move on to 4th part. Fourth part is consisting of a mixed fraction and a proper fraction. It is 6 plus 1, 7 by 3, divided by 3 by 5. It is equivalent to reciprocal of 3 by 5, which will be equal to 5 by 3. What we did, we interchanged numerators and denominators. We can't cancel out anything, so 7 into 5, 3 into 3, this is 35 by 9. Again, improper fraction. Okay, so this is our answer. Now we will do one more part. And with that, we will complete the exercise. We will do seventh part. It is consisting of two mixed fractions, 3 by 5, divided by 1, 2 by 3, 2 by 3. Convert both mixed fractions to improper fraction. It is 16 by 5 divided by 5 by 3, it is equal to 16 by 5 into reciprocal of 5 by 3. Reciprocal of 5 by 3 will be 3 by 5. 3 by 5. Okay? We can't cancel out anything. So it will be equal to 16 into 3. And 5 into 5, which will be equal to 25, 48 by 25, it is a mixed fraction, we will convert it into mixed fraction, which will be equal to 123 by 25. And this will be our answer. We have completed the exercise. In next class, we'll be doing 2.5, which is dealing with decimal number. We'll starting with decimal numbers. Have a good day.